Hi there.
In this video, we'll be talking about text wrap in InDesign, so let's get started. I have this document here filled with text already, so I need to place an image in the center of this page. Let me grab the rectangle frame tool and make a frame in here. And with my frame selected, let's go to File, and then Place, and locate the image on the computer, and hit Open. Let's click the image to select it, and then right-click and go to Fitting, and then select Fit Frame to Content option, and the image shall expand to fill in the frame. Let's drag to center align the image. At this point, the text is hidden behind the image, so let's change that by going to Window and then Text Wrap. You can see that no text wrap option is selected at the moment. Click the image once to select it, and then click the icon right next to the selected option, which says Wrap Around Bounding Box. And the text should roll around the image or the bounding box, so to speak. However, the problem is that it is still touching the image, so we need to have some sort of padding around the image. Click the link icon in the center so that updating one side updates all. Increase the size of one of the sides and it shall add a padding all around the image. I think P6 should be good enough. And that's how you text wrap around an image. Now let's move on to another page and try it with a letter. With the text tool, make a large text box on the pasteboard and type in the letter T. Let's select the letter and change the font to Poppins Black or any other chunky font of your choice and update the font size to 300 points. If you move this letter on top of the text and click the Wrap Around Bounding Box option, this is what happens. It is wrapping around bounding box, which is the frame in this case, and that's not what we want. We want the text to come close to the edges of the letter. So to do that, with the letter selected, go to Type and select Create Outlines. So now the letter is not a font anymore. It's been transformed into a shape. Let's center align the shape and let's zoom in as well. This time we need to select the third option from the left, which is Wrap Around Object Shape. And you see the text is almost touching the boundaries of the shape. If you try the second option, you'll find the bounding box returns to haunt us. And we don't want that, so select the third option from the left. The reason why you see only one offset option highlighted is because the shape is not rectangular, like in case of the image we inserted earlier. So when we increase the offset, it will increase proportionately from all sides, as you can see. You can play with wrap options here as well. So if we select right side, text is thrown to the right side. Left side selection also gives similar result. Selecting both right and left sides is the most apt option for our shape. Slide towards spine will slide the text towards the spine area, which is the center of the two facing pages. Similarly, slide away from spine will throw the text to the opposite side of the spine. Largest area will not make much of a difference than both right and left sides, so we're going to stick to both right and left sides option. Lastly, you can also try jump object option from top, and you shall find it restricting the text on both sides of the shape. Jump to next column will even throw away the text beneath the shape to the next page, so depending upon the situation, you as a designer need to decide what to choose here unless clearly specified otherwise by the client. The invert checkbox will invert the area on both sides of the shape, so at the moment there is text, and check the invert box and the text is swept clean. Let's uncheck the invert box to get back to our settings. It's a nice fun tool and makes your text as creative as you can make it to appear, so do make good use of it. Alright guys, that concludes our session and I'm going to see you in the next one in just a bit. Goodbye.